Coach Rick McConnell joins me from Pilot-Mound, Manitoba with the update on the male hockey team. Good morning, Rick. How was the snowfall yesterday?
Well, we got a lot more than expected. So she's winter wonderland out here now.
That's good. So did everything melt prior to, or most of the ditches, everything's all white now, you said?
No, everything's all white. We got probably half a foot of snow, so it's really icy.
Yeah, we got about a couple inches up here, so I think this one's going to stick around. It's supposed to stay a little bit cooler than normal. Let's talk less about weather. Let's talk more about hockey. We've got a first ever Pilot Mound Winter Classic happening for the boys team. Five other teams invited, two of them from Winnipeg, and then Prairie International and Fernie from BC. What is your expectations for this weekend playing two of the three teams from high schools in Winnipeg?
Well, we brought in some different teams, so that, because we do have some academy teams, and we wanted some different teams for everybody to play. For being our first year, we're just trying to get our first year under our belt. So I'm looking forward to it. It gives those other academy teams a chance to play this high school elite team. And the coach Mike Wake was willing to split up and make two teams to come out here to kind of get this tournament under us going. And next year we'll try to expand, but I'm looking forward to some different competition, and I'm actually looking forward to see the CSHL teams back again.
Yeah, you've had a little bit of time off with the boys, a lot of practice time. What have you been working on the last couple of weeks?
Yes, we've had a lot of time. We went really heavy there for quite some time, and we've been working on everything. I'm always working on our D zone. We spend a lot of time on that, but our club at times has trouble passing the puck up to my standards, so we spend a lot of time doing transition, moving the puck, keeping our feet moving, and I'm a high-tempo guy. I want our game to be high-tempo, so I've been trying to push the pace with the boys at practice as well.
So we're working on the pace. First game is tonight at 7:30 versus that high school Elite One. I guess there's no real difference. Like you said, the high school team split squad. So the one team that you're playing tonight, have you had a chance to do some scouting on them or look at them and find out, or is it just basically your mentality of playing your game, sticking to your game plan, and let them morph out what they have to get done?
Yeah, it's more or less us playing our game. They're bringing two teams, and I'm not sure exactly how they mix them up, and it doesn't matter. I'm more looking at this weekend is to work on our game. We have lots to work on and continue to work on so we can be the best we can be at the end of the season. So I'm just looking for a good weekend of hockey, playing at our pace, playing at our level the way I want us to. And I think we're ready. The kids have had some real good practices here, and they're ready to play some games again. We had a couple there last weekend, but we're ready to play a weekend of hockey. So I'm looking forward to it.
Do your kids enjoy playing this 4-5 game setup within 72 hours? I mean, I know it's exciting. I know it's hockey, but is there a breaking point to too many games in a weekend, or just let them go?
Oh, no. Four games for me in a weekend is plenty. Sometimes we have played five or six, and some of the tournaments you may get to where you have to play six games, and if you get to that fifth or sixth, well, that's a bonus because you've done something well over the weekend. But four is a good weekend for me because, like I said, the competition is quite high, so you're playing at a pace that – it challenges these kids. So, but on the other hand, the kids want to play. They don't like sitting around. So playing the games is a benefit as well.
So first game tonight, 7:30. Tomorrow night, 7:30 against Fernie. You haven't played Fernie yet, have you? Or are they part of the CSHL?
No, they're part of our league in the States, North American Prep League, and we have played them once. Okay. We beat them. I can't remember the score, but they're a good team too, so it's another team that we don't see a whole lot of. We see a little bit down in the States, but we thought it was a chance to bring somebody in that some of the other teams wouldn't have seen.
Was there anything to the draw setting up these teams in which Pool A, Pool B? I mean, you have two other CSSHL teams in your division, and you're playing the other high school teams in Fernie that's not part of that secondary school hockey league. Was that by setup, or is that just by the luck of the draw?
No, we did that by setup to give the CSHL teams a chance to play different teams. We will cross over depending on how it goes. But, yes, that was done on purpose so that We see a lot of IHA and Prairie during the regular season. So yeah. We were just happy they would come. So we worked it out that they could see some different teams. But we may end up playing them, which is fine because they're both good clubs. But this was set up so they could see some different teams, yes.
So everyone's got a pretty heavy schedule for the first couple of days. And then Sunday, everyone's going to be thinking about Grey Cup in the evening. But we got hockey at night. The potential of, you know, the way it's set up, you've got two semifinals in the morning, and then you've got a third place game, and then you've got the finals game. Is that still the setup for four games on Sunday?
Yes, it is, yeah.
So that's basically playing two games with a six-hour turnover or less than for that championship game. That's going to be pretty testing. Is that an endurance tester? Is that making sure that everyone's keeping everyone healthy? I mean, what's the best part about playing two games in a five, six-hour turnover?
Well, you don't have much time to sit around and think about what's going to happen. Again, if you get to Sunday and you can win and get into the final, you should have enough energy and adrenaline left to go out and play the best you can. We've been in that situation a few times, and actually I felt our kids have played, my club has played quite well when we've got to the finals, being tired. So it's just a matter of going out there, playing the game, and not worrying about the Bombers for a couple hours.
we'll leave the gridiron to the gridiron. Let's deal with a 85 by 200 rink first. And I have to ask you this last question. How is the team? Are they well-rested, injury-wise? We all set to go?
Well, we're rested. I think we've had good practices. I'm banged up a little bit. We've got a couple injuries. I'm not sure if the guys will play tonight or not. We're gonna see when we get to the rink. But overall, we're okay. I think we've had good practices. We're prepared. It's just, and we won't be tired. We might be tired from practicing, but
there you go.
The energy seems to be good. The guys were kind of jumping yesterday, ready to get going and play some games with some meaning here. So looking forward to it.
That's absolutely right. So big, heavy weekend. Go check it out, Blackjack Stewart Arena. Lots of great hockey from all over Canada, really, the western side especially. I mean, Prairie representing Saskatchewan. IHA is from where again?
Calgary.
Calgary. So you've got Saskatchewan, Alberta, BC, Manitoba. You've got the whole Fandango set up here, and I really think it's going to be a great turnout and become larger in years to come. Last question, Rick. Do you consider yourself more a Sheldon Keefe kind of coach or a Mike Babcock kind of coach?
Good question. I'm somewhere in the middle. I am old school, pretty firm, but I'm also, I would say I'm a little bit of both. When I think about it, you know, I've worked under Rod for the first two or three years, which really got me back into a little bit of the old school style to coaching, but I also have my own style. I'm a little bit more player coach friendly. But when push comes to shove, I still have high expectations, and I might tend to be a little bit more old school.
That's a good, we'll call it the blend. We'll call it the bit of this and a bit of that. Clearly you're not getting fired on the road anymore anytime soon, Rick, and you've done a great job with these boys. I mean, as the games I've seen this year have been pretty fantastic, very fast, great passing. I know you can always say you can improve on that, but these kids are flying, and they've got a good chemistry started, and it's building, I know.
I can't hear you anymore.
Okay, we'll let it go there. Rick, thank you so much. We'll cut it there.
I can't hear you, Theo.